years ago, Qasim Ali Shah came to know that I am running a program named Whiz Kids. Whiz Kids is a program of little small children from class 5 to class 10 or something like that. And that we used to run, and it was a 3 weeks program. And I got a ring from Qasim Ali Shah, and he says, I want to attend that Whiz Kids program. I said, look, this is for class 5 to class 10, this program. Are you a child? He said, no. I said, then why do you want to attend this? He said, I want to learn how you teach the children. And I have gone through the syllabus and I'm impressed and I want. I said, then you come on only one condition. And that condition is that for those 3 weeks, you become a child. Children playing games, exercises, and whatever it comes to, you become a child. I said, yes, I will become a child. And believe me, for all those 3 weeks, he was a perfect child. When I was thinking of telling you something about NLP, I was wondering in my mind, what should I tell you? NLP is a huge, big subject. On each of its sub-subjects, we can talk for hours and days. So how can I summarize and make it very simple and easy for you to understand what I tell you about NLP? It is a challenge for me. Neuro Linguistic Programming, NLP. It's a science of excellence. Two people got together to make a project, to work on a project, and they thought that if there is somebody who is doing very well, let's say Qasim Ali Shah is doing very well in his field, and there are some other trainers who are somewhere in between, and still other trainers was somewhere very, very at a low level. And so what's the difference? Why is it that somebody in a profession does very well and somebody is just mediocre and can't rise above the ground? Why is it? What is the difference in the people, what they do? So what do the successful and brilliant and excellent people do other than what a normal person is not doing? So they studied that. And that's how NLP was born. The basis of NLP are our five senses. Visual, seeing. You can see me, I can see you. Hearing, you can hear me, I can hear you. Touch and feel and movement. In NLP, touch and feel and movement we call kinesthetic. It's an English term, NLP term. But meanings, feeling, touch, and movement. Visual, auditory. Auditory means hearing. Auditory means
hearing.
Kinesthetic means touch, feeling, movement. Senses, these are our senses, three major senses. And then smell and taste. Five senses. Major senses. Visual, auditory, hearing, kinesthetic, touch, feeling, movement, VAK. We'll be talking about it, VAK, very often, so I have written on the board. These senses are not just senses. These are systems. And systems means externally we see, hear, feel, and internally we see, hear, and feel. Now look at your home. Just look at your home internally. Visually, imagine your home. You can. Imagine your kitchen. You can. Everybody can.
Yes, sir.
Hear somebody calling your name. Hear somebody calling your name. You can hear it.
Yes, sir.
Now imagine your right hand in a cold water bucket. Imagine, just imagine, feel your right hand in a cold water bucket. Can you feel the cool water on your hand?
Yes, sir.
All of you can feel that?
Yes, sir.
So these are internal senses. So that makes a system. External and internal senses. So that makes a system. Can we learn? My question to you is, can we learn anything without the use of these senses?
No.
No, it's not possible. So that means these senses are the systems through which we learn anything. All of us have visual, auditory, and kinesthetic senses. However, each one of us has one sense more developed. That means preferred sense. One sense out of these is developed more in all of us. So what? If it is so, then so what? That means a lot. Because if somebody's visual sense is developed more, then what happens? Can you imagine what would happen if somebody's visual sense is developed more?
He learned more through visual sense.
Learn more through visual sense. Use all this sense all the time, most of the time. Look at everything from visual point of view. The clothes will be matching. The pictures in the mind will run fast. Person will speak faster. And at home and at office, things will be arranged meticulously, spotlessly clean. Because everything is revolving around
visual.
The person cannot stand, you know, dirty things, uncleanliness, or mismatching things. So his life or her life is round and round, going around, mostly around the visual sense. That is the biggest talent of that person, visual. And if that person's kinesthetic sense and feelings is less developed or least developed, then what will happen? What will happen then?
He will be less sympathetic.
The person will hardly feel the feelings of him or herself or himself and of others. A feeling less person. And somebody whose auditory is developed, they will be musicians and they will be very good at talking and very conscious of their voice. And who are the sportsmen? The kinesthetic people. If this sense is developed highly, such people go into feelings most of the time. And when they are talking, they talk a little slowly because they have to talk through their feelings. And they are very good sportsmen. It just comes naturally. So these are actually our talents. The senses, the systems are our talents. Somebody is talented at something. It's the sense is developed. Ideally, what should happen? If you want to see the world as it is really, closer to the world. Now this person's, through these senses, we make a very important point.